Hi guys, Ali here, your personal technical trainer. Today in this video, we're going to talk about Windows Sandbox. Have you ever received a file that you did not know if it's safe or not? Have you ever had a situation that somebody gave you an application, but you were not sure if you can run it without affecting your computer safety? Have you ever been in a situation that one of your employees have left the company, but not in good terms, so there are files that you're not 100% sure if are safe, or they might be infected? How do you test that? Traditionally, we had to go ahead and install a new virtual machine, test the application, and delete that file and the virtual machine altogether. This required a lot of hours to install a virtual machine completely from scratch, do the test, and delete the virtual machine. With the introduction of Windows Sandbox, we don't need any of those steps anymore. Windows Sandbox provides you a light version of your desktop in a virtual environment, so you can easily test any file. The advantage of Windows Sandbox is that it is temporary, so once you close it, the software, all the files, and everything related to that virtual machine is deleted forever. Every time you open up the new sandbox, it will create a new sandbox for you. So if you have several applications that you need to test, you just need to close it after your test is done and reopen it. It will create a new instance for you. If you are having Windows 11 build 22.509 or later, there is a good news for you. If you initiate a restart from inside your virtual environment or your sandbox, the state of the file would be untouched. It is great when you need to install an application that requires a restart. On the older versions of the sandbox, if you install an application and you initiate the restart from even inside the VM, it would delete everything. But with this version, you have the option to initiate a restart from inside the sandbox and continue where you need it to work from. Software and applications that are installed on the host are not directly available on your sandbox. Whatever you have installed on your host computer is completely isolated and separate. The files that are on the sandbox are isolated from the operating system as well. Once you complete the test and close the sandbox, everything would be deleted. Now let's go and see how do we enable and install Sandbox. First, we need to check our operating system version. For that, you can go to the Start menu, Run, and type in WinVir. Windows version shows your installed operating systems. In my case, I have Windows 11 Enterprise operating system installed. And as we said before, Sandbox is only available on Windows Pro and higher. If you have a Windows Home, Sandbox would not be available. In order to enable and install Windows Sandbox feature, we need to turn on one of the Windows features. There are multiple ways for activating or installing Windows features. First of all, you can go to your Start menu and search for Turn on Windows feature. Turn Windows features on or off. That's one option. And if you like to use shortcuts, again, you can go to Run menu and type in app wiz.cpl, that's application wizard.control panel. By clicking that, it will take you to the programs and features on your computer. Now you have the option to select turn Windows features on or off. From here, we need to scroll all the way down until we see Windows Sandbox. Select Windows Sandbox, click OK, and this will install Windows Sandbox for you. This will require a restart. We will continue the video after the restart is completed. Once your computer is restarted, we can start using Sandbox by going to the Start menu and searching for the Sandbox. If you go to the All Programs, scroll down, you can see the Sandbox, or you have the option to type in the search menu. Windows Sandbox. It's always best to run Windows Sandbox as an administrator, so that's what we're going to select. Once you open the Windows Sandbox, you will see that it will create a very brief and summarized version of our own operating system. So it's exactly the same replica of our own operating system, but it runs in an isolated environment. Whatever you do inside the sandbox is just for testing purposes. And once you close the sandbox, everything would be deleted. As we explained earlier, one prime example of using Windows Sandbox is when you would like to test a new applications. How do we transfer files between our Windows and the Sandbox? That's easy. I've already downloaded a test file, which we're going to do an installation on the Windows Sandbox. You just need to copy the file and paste it on your Windows Sandbox. Keep in mind, the drag and drop does not work. You can only copy and paste. Now I'm pasting the file and let's test it. Imagine that this is a file that you received. You're not sure about the safety of this file. We need to test it without affecting our own operating system. So I can run it here, install it, do the test. And if it's not dangerous to my computer, if it's not malicious, then I can use it on my own actual computer. There is a new thing that you need to keep in mind. If you initiate a restart from inside your Windows Sandbox, that will not delete the files from your sandbox. If I shut it down, it will delete everything. The entire virtual machine and all the files associated with it would be deleted. But if I do a restart from inside the sandbox, the files would stay untouched. What is it good for? For testing the applications that require restart. If you are testing an application which requires you to restart in order to complete the setup, you need to initiate the restart from inside your sandbox. And as you see, looking at this operating system, it is the minimal version. It doesn't have any of the built-in applications installed to it. It just has the core features and functionality of Windows for our testing purpose. And now we see the application that we wanted to test is installed. If I go ahead and close this sandbox, it's going to prompt me that it's going to delete the entire files and everything would be discarded permanently. That's exactly what we need. As a side note, if you decided to install and enable Windows Sandbox on a virtual machine, a machine that's already virtualized, you might not be able to do it at first, but there are always ways and solutions to bypass that. This is a virtual machine running on VMware. If I go ahead and start installing the sandbox, you will see that the sandbox feature is grayed out. I will not be able to turn on this feature. And the reason it says the CPU or the processor does not have the required feature or the required virtualization capabilities. So how do we overcome that? That's very easy. You just need to go into your VMware virtual machine setting. I'm going to shut down this VM. Then you need to go to the virtual machine settings, select the processor, and enable Intel VT. This feature tells your VMware workstation to allow CPU to do a nested virtualization. It is a VM by itself, but now we are asking it to allow another virtual machine running inside this virtual machine. That is called nested virtualization. select Enable Intel VT, click OK, and turn back your VM. And now if I go back to the installation, I can see the Windows Sandbox is available for me to install. If you are installing the Sandbox on a physical computer and you still don't see the Sandbox option available to you, that means that you have not enabled virtualization technology on your computer's BIOS. So you have to enable virtualization in your computer's BIOS and then come back, continue with the rest of the process. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Thank you for watching and hope to see you on the next video.